Okay, so this is a it's a Singer Futura quartet, but it's also a top load bobbin. And so I'm going to be showing you how to check the timing on this. This machine actually has several problems. I've got to service it. I've got to find why it's locking up and stuff, but I'm also going to use it to show you how to check the timing on a top load bobbin. So with that, we're gonna get started. Okay, so again, this is the second video in the timing series of my videos. And I'm gonna go over in this one how to check the timing on a top load bobbin. Now, in the first video, I went over how to check the timing on a front load bobbin. And I also went over needles and exactly how they work and stuff. So if you missed that, and if you need that information, then there should be a link in the top right hand corner of this video that you can click on and go watch that video if you need to. This one I'm going to go over checking the timing on the top load bobbin, and I'm also going to show you in this video on this particular machine. Now, keep in mind, this is a Singer. A lot of the newer Singers are very similar. So I'm going to go over in this video how to adjust the needle hook clearance should you need to adjust it. And again, a lot of the newer Singers are very much the same. They're very, very similar. We're going to start with the needle on the left-hand side, then we'll go to the right-hand side, then we'll set it in the middle, okay? And the reason I'm starting on the left-hand side is I wanna make sure that the needle comes in just above the eye, okay? When I'm setting a timing on one of these, I want to make sure that I get it. I set it at its lowest point first and its highest point. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So the needle's coming down. As you can see, it's going to come down. Now I want to point out, I also talked to you in the other video about ensuring that the needle was properly installed and all the way in. Again, if you need to see that, if you need to understand that, then check that other video. The link should be in the top on the right-hand side. But if your needle is not all the way up at this point, you can see how close it is to this bobbin, to this hook down here, right? If it's not all the way up, it's going to scrape that. So it's going to scrape your hook. So if your hook has scrapes on it right here, more than likely it is from the needle not being installed all the way up, and that's what's caused it. That will damage your needle. And if your needle hits this one time, you need to replace your needle because you damaged your needle. So hitting it will damage your needle. And as well, it can cause you problems with your needle bar. If it's far enough down, it could possibly push your needle bar up, which has now got your machine all messed up. Okay. So always make sure, always make sure that you get your needle all the way up. All right. Now, as you can see, it's coming around, your needle is starting up, okay? And then your hook is coming around right here. All right, your hook is coming right above the eye, all right? If you can see that, your hook is just above the eye right here, and that's exactly where you want it, is just above the eye. Okay, let me see, let me know if you can see that. Let me know if you have any problems or if you have any questions on this, okay? So on this machine, and normally on top load, normally with top load bobbin machines, your hook travels in this pattern, okay, travels this way, so that's counterclockwise. And so with it going counterclockwise, you're going to start checking your timing with the needle all the way to the left, just like this. And again, with that, you want the hook coming in just above the eye, and that is just barely above the eye, but it's within the scarf. Okay, you can see there that you can actually see the hook through the needle, the eye of the needle, right? So that hopefully that gives you a good idea and you understand what I'm talking about. Okay, so next I'm going to show you, once you establish that the timing looks good there, then we're going to take it the needle all the way to the left. Okay, we're going to do this again. It's going to come down, and again, if your needle is not properly installed, it's going to hit your hook. Okay, and it starts back up just like this, starting to move back up. And then the hook comes behind the needle. Okay, it's not quite behind it yet, but there it is. All right, and so you want to make sure, and I can tell you because I know, I'll see if I can show it to you here in a minute. You want to make sure that in both cases, well, especially this case, that the hook is in the scarf of the needle. All right, and again, if you don't understand the scarf, go check out that first video. Okay, so you can see right there, you see the hook, and you see that it is inside the scarf of the needle. I want you to pay attention to how close that hook is to the needle itself. Okay, you can see that, you can see how close it is. Now, this varies from machine to machine. One possible problem, like I talked about in the first video, is if your needle's not close enough to your hook, it can cause it to start skipping stitches. Okay, you want it fairly close. In that first video, it is very, very close. In fact, it's almost touching. Now, if you've got this much distance and it's working fine, then don't worry about it. But if you're within your scarf area, both on both sides, and it's skipping stitches, then the problem may be the distance of the needle from the hook. That's a fairly good distance right there, actually. And you really don't want it much further away than that. You start getting further away than that, and you're going to definitely be skipping stitches. And again, if your hook is falling within the scarf of your needle on both right and left, then you may need to check on adjusting the needle hook clearance. So we're going to go over how to check the needle hook clearance right Okay,
now.
I said that we were going to go over how to check needle hook clearance. That's what I just showed you. We're going to go over on this machine how to adjust that if you need to. Okay, so you've got your needle bar here and you follow it up. Okay, follow it all the way up to the top. Now we're going to turn the machine around because it's on the back. All right. Turn it right here. This piece right here hooks to the top of your needle bar assembly, and it moves it. Okay, in fact, it has it set. This inside your needle bar assembly has a spring, okay, and it's holding it this way. All right, it's keeping it held this way with that spring. So the way you adjust this forward and backwards is right here. You've got this set screw right here, and then this screw inside it is actually an Allen wrench. Okay, it's got a hole for an Allen wrench, which you can see right there. All right, so You need an Allen wrench that will fit this, and you will probably need a wrench to fit this. This little nut right here is really fragile, so you got to be careful. Normally, if you're trying to push the needle closer, so the way this is going to work is you will screw this in, which pushes the top of the needle further out and will bring the bottom of the needle closer to the hook, all right? So you need to determine which way you're going with this, and you're going to only adjust it in small increments, very, very small, okay? It's a good idea to have a flashlight and to watch as you adjust this. You're going to want to have the needle in the correct position down below so that you can see how close it's getting. And if you're going this way, usually you can just put an Allen wrench in this. I'm not going to adjust it because this one's setting right and I don't want to mess with it. And you turn it just a little bit. Remember, righty tighty's lefty loosey. So right on this is going to push it out, which is going to bring the needle closer this way to the needle bar. Now, you don't want to hit, you don't want the, or to the hook. It's going to bring the needle closer to the hook. Excuse me, I'm sorry. You don't want the hook hitting the needle. You can get it very, very close, like within the thickness of a piece of paper to the hook, okay? But you don't want it hitting it. And when you turn it, you'll be able to hear the hook hit the needle if it is, and you'll see the needle move a little bit. So make sure that you don't get it close enough that it's hitting it, but get it within the area that if the scarf wasn't there, if you understand that, if the cutout where the scarf is was not there, if it was just solid, then the hook would hit the needle, okay? So getting it that close is really kind of what you want to do if you have to adjust this. If it's not skipping, then don't mess with this, all right? This is very important. Make sure everything else is set before you mess with this. Now, if you need to bring the needle further away from the hook, then you're going to turn this to the left. Just little bits at a time. When you do that, it's probably going to back the screw off, okay? So you're going to need to make sure that once you turn a little bit, that you tighten the screw back up, and you will have to hold the Allen wrench while you tighten this. Otherwise, it will probably move this screw as well. So I hope you're understanding what I'm saying. Let me know in the comments if you understand what I'm saying. And you're still adjusting it the same. You want it just barely, it's barely not touching, where it's very close, okay? Let me know if you have any other comments. And again, if you have any other questions about the needle or how it's made or whatever, how it works, then go watch that other video, the first one in the series, which should be right up here. You should be able to click right up here on the right side of the screen and go watch that, all right? Y'all have a good day, and I'll talk to you later. By the way, if you found value in this video, please like and subscribe to the channel. And if you'd like to get notifications when I upload my next video before it actually goes live, then I have a link in the description below. Click on that and give me your name and email. And every time I upload a video before it actually goes live, I'll send you an email letting you know that it's out there, and you can go watch it right away before anybody else has a chance to see it. All right. Y'all have a great day, and I'll talk to you later. Thank you.